Welcome to the Folks Learn. Today we will learn how to implement custom paging in Data Grid View. First, you need to add a data grid view, a label and two buttons to form one. You can click Next button and Previous button for load the next and previous data sets respectively. You need to install PageList. To install PageList, right-click on your project and select Manage NuGet Packages. Search PageList and click Install. PageList makes it easier for .NET developers to write paging code. It allows you to take any enumerable and by specifying the page size and desired page index, select only a subset of that list. PageList also provides properties that are useful when building UI paging controls. We will use Entity Framework to get data from SQL Server. Entity Framework is an object relational mapper that enables .NET developers to work with relational data using domain-specific objects. It eliminates the need for most of the data access code that developers usually need to write. We will use the customer table in Northwind database to play demo. You can download the Northwind database below this video. Now, we will make an asynchronous method to get data from database. The async modifier indicates that the method, lambda expression, or anonymous method that it modifies is asynchronous. An async method provides a convenient way to do potentially long-running work without blocking the caller's thread. The caller of an async method can resume its work without waiting for the async method to finish. The method runs synchronously until it reaches its first await expression, at which point the method is suspended until the awaited task is complete. If a method that's modified by an async keyword doesn't contain an await expression or statement, the method executes synchronously. A compiler warning alerts you to any async methods that don't contain await because that situation might indicate an error. Thank you for watching this video.